Thank you. My name is Marie-Christine Wilmink, and I work advisor in the EU office in Brussels. And Pfizer is one of the collaborating partners of the Work Package 5. And I supported the European Cancer League and the Italian Cancer League in the organization of this youth promotion. I will first give a brief overview of the youth competition, but I will keep this very, very short, and not because we want to have lunch, but because all the teenagers are listening at the moment, and I'm sure that they want to hear whether they have won or not. So following my short overview, I will announce the winners of the competition. So about 1.5 years ago, the idea of organizing a youth competition was initiated by the European Cancer League and the Italian Cancer League. And the idea was to have a poster and a video competition, because it would be one of the activities to involve teenagers from around Europe in the European Week Against Cancer. So basically, it was an idea to reach the youth and to let them think about cancer prevention, and also to communicate cancer prevention to other teenagers. So following the initial idea, we had discussions in the Work Package 5 Advisory Council and also in the ECL boards. And here the idea was further refined, and also the competition rules were set. So some examples of the competition rules: teenagers from between 11 and 18 years old could participate, and in their posters and in their videos, the teenagers were asked to include one or more of the messages from the European Code Against Cancer. Well, the competition promotion. First of all, the competition was running from February until May 2012, and the competition was promoted through the ECL website, Facebook pages, the APAC partners, the European Youth Forum, and international schools in Europe. And by the end of May, we had collected all the submissions from around Europe. But most submissions came from Slovenia, and around 25% of the submissions were videos. So here you see examples of the posters, and I'm not sure how well you can see them, but they're all very beautiful, and some were serious, others had a funny touch. And many of them included the dangers of smoking. So, yes, I would like to just briefly mention the Slovenian case, because Slovenia was the country that that basically had most submissions, and it was because the promotion of the competition was led by the National Institute of Public Health in Slovenia, and they used the Slovene network of health promoting schools, and this network is part of the Schools for Health in Europe, an initiative from the World Health Organization, the EU, and European Commission. So basically, the National Institute of Public Health Slovenia, they sent a letter to the Slovene Network for Health Promoting Schools, and then they forwarded this letter about the youth competition to the regional coordinators from regional health institutes, and they then informed team leaders at individual schools, and the schools then approached the teachers, and the teachers informed the students. And obviously this sounds very logical, but Slovenia was really an exception in doing it like this, and it succeeded because they had most submissions. Why it worked in Slovenia, what I just mentioned, because they used all these different actors, and also because the APAC communication team and the secretariat, they responded very fast to the questions from the teachers and from the schools, and obviously not unimportant, the prizes were appealing. The voting rounds, there were two voting rounds, so when all videos and posters were submitted, we asked the ECL members, the APAC partners, and scouting groups to vote. And the scouting groups were asked because, yeah, they are teenagers themselves, and they obviously have a good understanding of what is important to teenagers. So the first round included all these submissions, they were voted on through SurveyMonkey, and then during the second round, the top three was ranked. So the final finalists were ranked, and I wanted to thank all of you who have voted, because you've spent a lot of time on it, and I'm very happy that you took the time to vote, and I'm sure that the children are very happy as well, because now it's time to announce the winners. So I hope that all listeners are able to see it as well, and hopefully can see their poster or video. So all prizes, they will be provided by the Italian Cancer Leagues. And the prizes are as follows. The third prize includes digital cameras, and the prize will go to the Checkmate poster from the IIS and Guggenheim School from Italy. So you will win a digital camera. Congratulations. Then the second prize includes iPod touches. The second prize will go to the painting, the Slovenian painting. And this is a painting painted by students from the secondary school of nursing in Ljubljana. And then the last prize, the first prize, which are iPads to all the winners, will go to the girl in the mirror from Italy, Instituto Martini da Vinci. Congratulations. So I want to thank all teenagers who participated in the competition. You have all done a great job. All videos and posters are beautiful, and you can all see them on the website weekagainstcancer.eu. So again, many thanks, and